Good morning to everyone. Myself, I'm P. Jayarangaram. And today we would like to discuss the topic, periodic properties from the basics of chemistry. Friends, now let me explain what is known to be the periodic properties. The periodic properties, the elements are classified in the century of 1865, I'm repeating, by Lavoisier. Now I'll ask you a question, right? How the elements are identified? Initially, the chemical elements were identified by the metal extraction process, right? Some of the elements, they were extracted from the deep earth crust. When they are extracted from the deep earth crust, some of the elements were metals and some of the elements are non-metal, and some of the elements having metal non-metal property, they are known to be that metalloid. Now, how they are differentiating the element belonging to an organic or inorganic? The element which containing carbon rich species along with the carbon, if it containing hydrogen, it is known to be organic. The elements or the atom, the individually, they doesn't containing carbon plus hydrogen. Okay, and individual elements, they are known to be that inorganic. But initially, what they have extracted? The first basic thing we would like to see that how the elements are extracted, how the elements are isolated, how many elements are isolated, and number two, and how they give the naming in the periodic table. Friends, in 1865, about 63 elements in 1865, they were prepared, okay. And after that, in 1940, and some of the other elements also extracted, the total elements extracted up to 1940 is equals to 115. And these elements are assigned the naming based on their atomic number and as well as and their electrolytic configuration. Now we will see step by step. The first one I'm saying, Debnor's laws of triads. What is meant by Debnor's laws of triad? A German scientist, it is known to be Debnor in the century of 1829. I'm repeating, in the century of 1825. Now he explains triad. What is meant by triad? Initially, he is explaining about the few elements. They are in the triad. I will tell you what is meant by triad. The word triad indicating that he is explaining three set of elements. I'm repeating. He is explaining the three set of elements, and the three set of elements having the similar property. Now, when we are taking the three set of elements, the central element containing the average atomic mass when compared with the top element and as well as the bottom element. I will give you the clarity. Now see this. According to that, the law of triad, now we can have some examples here. The first one I'm taking is a lithium. The second one is potassium. The third one is sodium. You see here, atomic weight of lithium is 7. Atomic weight of potassium is 39. Now when we are taking the average is similar to 23. Okay, 39 plus 7 divided by 2. Like this, I'm taking calcium. I'm taking barium. The mean value, the average value of calcium in the barium, it is approximately 80. According to Debnorians, right? Debnorian triads. Now he explained there's a table, and the table what we are taking as a triad table. In the triad table, now we are taking a set of elements, and each set containing three elements. I'm repeating. Each of the set containing three elements. Now these three elements are the set one. And these three elements are set two. And these three elements, what I'm saying is set three. Okay, now, and these three sets, I would like to mention one thing that they're having the similar property. And based on the property, now they're explaining this is going to be a set of elements, and the set of element containing the similar property. Now, when we are taking the middle element, and the middle element containing atomic weight, I'm repeating. The middle element containing the atomic mass, that is the average of the first element and the third element. Okay, now it is known to be that they've not tried. Okay. Friends, but there are some drawbacks identified for Debonair, and before going to the limitation, I will tell you how he is classified based on their properties and as well as physical chemical properties. According to the Debonair's explanation, the elements with the similar properties, the elements with the similar chemical property and the elements with the similar physical property, they should be arranged in the same group. I'm repeating. Okay? I will tell you the group what we contain is three elements. The group containing three elements, the group containing three elements, what we are saying as a set, and this set is known to be triad. Okay, now let's have some of the limitations that can explain some of the limitations of Debonair's triad. The first limitation I'm explaining, this law failed to explain for the low mass and high mass elements, right? I will tell you what is meant by low mass and high mass element. Based on that atomic weight and atomic number, we can identify the elements like hydrogen, helium. Lesser is the atomic weight, lesser is the atomic number, and like that the limits greater than 56, then more is the atomic weight and more is that atomic mass. Now we can have an example here, fluorine, chlorine, bromine. I'm taking the fluorine, chlorine, bromine as an example. Fluorine atomic weight is 9, chlorine 17, and bromine is 36. When we are taking these elements like fluorine, chlorine, bromine, the mean of that central atom, I'm repeating, the mean of that central chlorine is not exactly the average of the first and third element, chlorine and as well as the bromine. Now, it is the first drawback of Debonair triad. I'm repeating. According to the Debonair's triad, now he identified some elements, and those elements he is taking into a set, each set containing three elements. And the set, when we are discussing about the set, and the set, the third element, first element, right? Based on their atomic masses, they are arranged in a ascending order, element 1, element 2, element 3. The three elements, the triad, which is arranged in the increasing atomic mass. I repeat, which is arranged in the increasing atomic mass. The middle of the element containing atomic mass average of the first and as well as third element. But this application is not applicable in the case of low mass, high mass, and as well as halogen. Now we will see the continuation here. The next one, what we are saying is Newland's law of octave. I'm repeating. Newland's law of octave. Newland's law of octave in 1865. Newland's law of octave. Newland's in the year 1865. He explained about some of the elements, they're having similar physical chemical properties. Some of the elements which is having the similar chemical properties. I'm keeping a star here. Just concentrate, right? Okay. Some of the elements which is having a similar chemical property when we are comparing the first element with that eighth element. Okay. Then eighth element with the plus 8, 16th element. Or I'm taking second element in the group or period, second element, now the ninth element having the same property. Or if you are comparing with that atomic mass is equals to 3 and 3 with the 10. So I'm saying that when we are taking the atomic number is equals to 1 in the same group, atomic mass equals to 8, based on that Newland octave rule, based on that Newland octave, the element which containing atomic mass equals to 1, atomic mass equals to 8, having the similar properties like this. We can take any of the element in the group or the period. For suppose I'm taking atomic mass is equals to 2. Now I'm compared with that atomic mass that is equals to 9. Okay. The differentiation what we are taking as an octave. Well, the word octave is nothing but just you're taking atomic number 2. Just you're adding plus 8. Okay, then now based on all this comparison, octave indicating that there might be difference of 8 elements, and then the differentiation they're having the similar chemical properties. Now we will see in detail what is meant by Newland octave. Friends, this is the table which is explained in 18th century, right? 1865. According to that, Newland explained, you see here. According to that, Newland explained the Newland software. Okay, now here, I'm taking this hydrogen and they compare with the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And here I'm taking the fluorine and both having the similar property. Okay, now like this. Like this, they're explaining Newland software based on that Newland active. When we are taking all these elements up to 56, now we'll tell you what is meant by Newland's calculation. The how the Newland explain the elements' physical chemical properties. Okay, the Newlands identified about 56 elements in the year 1865. I'm repeating. Okay, now the first element starts with hydrogen, and the last element which ends with thorium is equals to 56. Okay, then the octave condition is the thing that octave rule. For each 8 elements, they're having the similar chemical property. I'm repeating. Each element containing the similar chemical property. And the continuation. Now, the elements with a similar chemical property are the present in the horizontal. Okay. Then, now we can have some of the conclusions for Newland's calculation. Now, we're discussing about Newland table. In the Newland table, the top of the element is hydrogen. Hydrogen having the similar property compared with the fluorine. Okay. The properties of hydrogen and the fluorine and the chlorine, they are known to be similar. Now, again, I would like to go through the table. I would like to come back to the table. See also. Now see. The elements, what we're discussing here. The elements what we have discussed here, just concentrate. You see this. The first one, hydrogen. Then you can add, you can take eighth element, fluorine. You can take next eighth element is known to be chlorine. Seventh. Okay. Now, when we are taking the elements like hydrogen, lithium, hydrogen, and lithium, then based on the atomic number, then they're taking the elements in the order. The first element with that eighth element having the similar chemical properties. And this point is very, very important. According to Newland octave, now he is taking the vertical line and the horizontal line. They arranged the atoms, the vertical and the horizontal line. Now, based on that octave condition, the elements having octave rule, that means atomic number 1, atomic number plus 8, just like hydrogen with the fluorine, just like lithium with the sodium. Now when we're taking all these elements in a sequence, they're having the similar chemical property. Friends. Now, discussing about Newland's, right? Now, coming back to our topic, then the properties of hydrogen here. What Newland states about this is the properties of hydrogen, the properties of fluorine, and the properties of chlorine are similar based on the octave rule. Similarly, if it starts with the lithium, and the 8th element, sodium, and the coming 8th element, potassium. I'm repeating. Lithium, sodium, and potassium. They're having the similar properties. Okay. Now we're discussing according to the Newland's method, Newland's principle, according to the Newland's calculation, or according to the Newland's chemical properties calculation, when we are taking the elements in that horizontal and the vertical line. Simple, friends. When we are taking the elements in the vertical and the horizontal line, like hydrogen, fluorine, chlorine, okay? The next hydrogen, the next eighth element is fluorine. The next eighth element will be chlorine. Lithium, the next eighth element will be sodium. The next eighth element will be potassium. And these elements having the similar chemical properties, Newland explained about the similar chemical properties in the same way. But it is having some certain drawback, and some of the elements that are having dissimilar properties, even though they were arranged in the same group. I'm repeating. Some of the elements which is having dissimilar properties, they are in the same group. Now, because of these drawbacks and this Newland's calculation, the Newland's method and Newland's theory is also failed, right? Now, let's see this. Cobalt, nickel, and as well as palladium, platinum. I'm picking cobalt, nickel, palladium, platinum, which do not have in the same property. Now, they were arranged in the same group. The elements with a dissimilar property, which is arranged in the same group, is known to be the another setback of the Newland. Next one. The next setback is when we are discussing about the Newland periodic table. I'm repeating. When we are discussing about the Newland periodic table, in the Newland periodic table, the restriction is about only 56 elements. The restriction is about 56 elements, right? Now, this is another drawback. The first drawback, average of atomic mass for some group of elements like halogen elements, just previous class we have discussed, right? The average of some elements not exactly or not nearer to the middle element. According to Newland calculation, according to the first Debner calculation, what he says is the average of the element should be in the middle of the element, and that might be false. The first one is Debner's, the second one is Newland's. When we are discussing Newland calculation, Newland's octave calculation, at this Newland octave calculation, based on the Newland octave calculation, the elements having octave, which is having a similar property, they were arranged in the same group. But some of the elements, they are having dissimilar property, even though they are also arranged in the same group. This is going to be the drawbacks of Newland. Now we're discussing about Mendeleev periodic table. And before going to Mendeleev periodic table, let me explain the first two calculation. The first one is Debner's, the second one is Newland. Can we see the few of outlines again? When we're discussing about Debner triads, which is explained in the century of 1829, I'm repeating, which is explained in the century of 1829, according to Debner, is explained law of triads. Debner's law of triads. The weight of the middle element, I'm repeating, the weight of that middle element is the average of the first and the final element. Triad means three elements. What is triad? Triad which containing three elements, element one, element two, element three. The middle element having the average is the average of the first and third elements. Now, here we can have some calculation. Lithium, potassium, the average element is sodium. Calcium and the barium, the average element is strontium. Calcium and the iodine, the average element is bromine. But this law is not ideal for all the elements. Some of the elements when we are taking, and this law might be deviates. Some of the elements like fluorine, chlorine, bromine. Now I'm taking this set. Chlorine bromine average not exactly or not similar to the chlorine, not nearer to the chlorine. The drawback. The second drawback, this law has failed to explain the low mass and as well as high mass elements. I'm repeating. This law fails to explain the low mass and as well as high mass elements. This is the second drawback. Next one. Next, we have discussed what is meant by Newland octave. Newland octave, the Newland method, which is explained in the century of 1865. Okay, according to the Newland, we're taking the three elements in a group. Okay, sorry, please. According to the Newland's octave, you're taking eighth element in the group having the similar chemical property. Newland explained about 56 elements in a Newland's table. You see, this is a Newland's table, Newland's periodic table. The first element is hydrogen, and the 56th element is thorium. Now, when we are comparing the eighth element containing the similar chemical properties, okay, it is having some drawback when we are taking the horizontal and as well as the vertical calculation. The horizontal containing the similar element with the similar property, but some of the dissimilar elements also arranged in the group. That is the first drawback, and the second drawback, this theory is restricted to only 56 elements. Newland is only explained about 56 elements in the periodic table. Next, the properties of dissimilar elements and as well as the set in the group, what he was designed, they are not ideal for all elements, right? Okay. The octave rules is not applicable to some of the elements which is arranged in the same group, like cobalt, nickel, palladium, platinum. For these elements, the rule is not applicable because even though you are applying the Newland's octave calculation, Newland's octave theory, but those elements which doesn't contain in similar properties. Now, these two theories identified initially in the periodic table calculation. Friends, the next continuation we are discussing about Mendeleev's periodic table, and the next one is the new Moseley's periodic table. Mendeleev's periodic table and the Moseley's periodic table we will see in the